Alright guys, welcome back to the channel once again, and today we're gonna be looking at some custom blocks into our builder. Last time we have added some blocks over here, some dummy blocks that we can just drag and drop, and we can see like things are getting added inside the canvas or not. But today we're gonna be adding some more well designed custom blocks and how those things work. So that's styling and all the things for those also we're gonna look into that, so how we can do that. So that's things we're gonna see. And also I'm just going to implement the Tailwind CSS into that, whatever the build, whatever the component you will see inside this canvas, those gonna be designed into the Tailwind CSS. So normally I'm not gonna write any code for those components. I will just pick those Tailwind CSS components from the website and just copy the code and paste inside the configuration, and the component gonna be loaded over here, and we can drag and drop and we can see. And also one more thing we cannot see today, like when we will add some buttons over here, like save button, and on save of that button we will get all the HTML CSS, and that gonna be get saved into the DB. So DB part we will see into the next video, but today we're gonna be adding the custom blocks and as well as the configuration table in CSS. So before doing all the things, we have to do one more configuration inside our grape.js config. So what is that? Let me show you. So we need to add the canvas into this one, and over here we have to add styles. So styles are those, like let's suppose you have multiple styles linked, like we add into the HTML file, you can see there are two links have been added. So you have multiple styles links, so you can add those links like this. You can add blah 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 and comma, so another link. So those links gonna be automatically get included inside your canvas HTML. Okay, so and also scripts if you want to add. So same thing for the scripts as well, you can add the script. So I'm just going to copy this script from here, Tailwind CSS script, and I'm just going to append it over here like this, and our Tailwind CSS script gonna be loading inside our page builder. Okay, so let's add one component from the Tailwind CSS component. So let's go into the Tailwind CSS components. Okay, and let's click on this one, and you can see we have several components over here that we can use. So let's click on this simple login form, and there are some forms that we can use. So just click on this one, let's see if we can get this or not. Yeah, so we can get this one, and show code. So this is the code for this template. So just copy this code from here and just go into the grape.js config. So earlier we defined some blocks, so where is that block manager? Okay, let's find it out. Okay, where is that block manager? Okay, so this is the block manager, and we are going to add one more block over here also. I'm just going to add it, like ID gonna be form one, label gonna be form one. Okay, and attribute, which means if you want to add some attribute inside this block, like any class or ID or whatever. So ID you have already defined, so let's suppose you want to define some class, so you can define it over here like this. So this is the HTML attribute of that block. Okay, and now final thing is that content, what the content you want to present. So I'm just going to add that content. Okay, so let me guide you a little bit inside of that. So you can see all the things are class based over here, all the things are Tailwind class related. And also in this one you can also write the style CSS. Okay, let's suppose if you have written some custom style over here, so you can write it like this for each and every block. Okay, like this, and you can write some style. I'll show you some component that has been dependent on this kind of a style. So you can write this style over there, and whenever you will drag that component and drop it inside the canvas, it will automatically get merged into the HTML CSS part of the editor. And let's see how it looks like inside our builder. So let's reload this one first. Okay, so our component is loading, and if I drag it over here, so you can see my form element is coming as it is, like it was looking over here. It's amazingly. We don't have to do any kind of hard work. Just copy the component code from here and paste it inside our configuration of Webpage Builder and load it. And you can, what you can do when we will add the save button, so you just need to click on that save and it's gonna be saved into your database. That's it. So let's find some more components and we're gonna be adding into our Webpage Builder. So this is Traversy Media page. So I'm just going to use this component. Let's copy this one and paste it inside the GrapeJS Builder. So just create another component over here. And ID form 2 label. And attributes, and you can find some attributes over here like this, and also just put the content. Content, and just copy these contents over here and relax, just sit back and relax and see the magic over here. Okay, so we have two form components. One is this one, you just need to load it and it's coming as it is. And let's drag this one after this one. So let's say this is the profile of him and this is our login form. So both the forms are coming over here and it looks good. It's looking really nice and I didn't do any kind of hard work on creating these blocks, so it's very easy to add these blocks. And a lot of people asked me earlier like how we can add the custom blocks. So I hope you guys understood like how we can add the custom blocks into our web page builder and we can reuse it again and again. So let's open the console and let me show you one thing that I'm just going to do in the next step. So let's stop and let's see we are getting the editor part or not. So we are getting editor and let's get the .get.html. So if I click on this, so you can see I'm getting whole HTML of my canvas editor. Okay, and same thing with the get.css. Okay, so I'm getting CSS. There is no CSS, so everything is class based, so there is no any custom CSS added over here. And if I do any change from this part, so the style gonna be added inside my webpage builder. Like if I click on this component and if I change some background color from here, let's see like this, and if I again hit the editor.get.css, so you can see I'm getting for this ID element background color this. So that's how it works. So let's add the button inside into the nav bar and let's save the contents. Okay, so let's add the button over here. Create a function in over here. Okay, inside this script, so create one function over here. Function save content. Okay, so this is our function which will save our content. But whenever we will click on that, so it will show us console.log editor.get.html comma editor.get.css. Okay, so let's call this function on click of that button. So there is a button, here it is. Okay, so on click save content. Okay, now let's see how it looks like and let's drag this. Okay, and save it. Did we get? So you can see I'm receiving the HTML, all the HTML content whatever I have inside my canvas editor. Okay, so again if I will do, let me show you again. So if I click on save, so you can see I'm getting over here. Let me just cancel it. And you can see on click of that button I'm getting the HTML and also as well as CSS part of this canvas. Okay, so whatever we have inside the canvas, we are getting these. So I hope you guys understood a lot of things from this video, like we can add the custom blocks. So as much as blocks you can add, just you have to define it to block those blocks inside this. And you can also create a plugin, and that plugin you can load like this, like this. You can plugins, and inside the plugins you can load multiple plugins inside this key, and those also those things gonna work. So, and also you can add the custom blocks like this if you are not understanding, and also you can prefer the plugins part as well. So let me show you into the GrapeJS, because it has been already defined, GrapeJS documentation. And if you go into the docs, and if you go into API reference, so if you see this plugins part, okay, so if you see this plugins part, so you can see there are multiple plugins that how you can add the plugins into your web page builder. So you have to use plugins, and that's how I show to you my plugin, my name package. So you can create separate repo for those plugins, like you can define your all the blocks into that separate repo, and you can make a build of that repo and add that build inside this plugins plugin key into the GrapeJS initialization, and that's that is gonna be your different kind of configuration scenario, and it's gonna be really understandable. Like it won't gonna make so much code clutter over here. So you can see I have defined everything into the same file, so it doesn't look good. Okay, so that's a kind of code writing technique. Then you can move these things into the separate file, and I'll show you into the later videos, because this is a kind of basic thing. So I'm just showing you straightforward right now. So thank you so much guys, thank you for watching, and I'll meet you in the next video. In the next video we will save our content into the DB, and we will get the content from there as well.